Arc'teryx has been in the hard shell category for over 20 years. At the time, we just saw this big need in the industry of something new and fresh. None of the products on the market really filled the need, and we saw a lot of potential for rethinking how hard shells were made. Within the hard shell category, we have five different sub-collections. SL, which is for super light, so the goal here is to reduce the weight as much as possible. Then we have the LT category, so this is just trying to make the product as light as we can while keeping it reasonably durable. And we have the FL category, which is for fast and light. So this is a really good balance of weight and durability with the essential feature set. Then we have the AR category, which is for all round. This is a collection we designed to be as versatile as possible. And then finally, we have the SV collection, which is for severe conditions. So we're using our most robust face fabrics and our most durable gore membranes. So with our constant need to evolve, we decided to revisit the Alpha FL for Spring 17. For that FL category, you want to make sure that you're not wasting time throughout the day changing layers, so breathability was really a key story in that. So going from 2014 to the newest Alpha FL for 2017, the goal is really refinement. So we knew what worked, it was working really well for us. It's definitely one of the athletes' favorite pieces because it's so light and compact and durable. But it was really just that next step of refining and working on ergonomics and really optimizing the feature set. Here we have both the 2014 Alpha FL and the new 2017 Alpha FL. So I'm just going to go through a few of the differences. Some things that we've refined are, you know, we eliminated the top stitching on the center front zipper. Anytime you have stitching, it's a sucker for water. We're also using the new RS slider, which seals the zipper when you pull it up. There's a couple advantages. For one, eliminating the zipper garage, you can eliminate the seam. Anytime you have a hard point under a textile, that's typically the first point to blow on the jacket. Just working with our warranty department, we were finding that there's a lot of oil contamination typically on the neck of any jacket, of any garment, especially when it's closer to your skin. There's a secondary layer, and that is kind of the sacrificial layer that absorbs all those contaminants and still protects the laminate package on the exterior part of the jacket. We're also using cohesive cord locks on the hem. So externally, it's very, very clean. We designed it so the tail of the shock cord aims up into the jacket, so you're not going to snag it on any carabiners or any gear or anything else. It's got some thickness and mass to it. So previously, we used to have these foam noodles in the hem of the jacket to keep it from rotting out under the harness. So since it has that thickness to it, it's kind of doing two functions in one. It's the cord lock, but it also keeps it under the harness. It's just the one piece that you can have it with you at all times. It packs super small, it's really light, it's really durable for how light it is, and you know, we've had some of our athletes taking this jacket up to 7,000 meter peaks, so it's very capable. The gore membrane that's used in the new Alpha FL is one of many used in the hard shell category. We have a deep partnership with WL Gore, working with them for over 20 years, developing solutions for protection from the elements. With our in-house design and prototyping capabilities, we're able to provide Gore with immediate feedback. We've got a huge team that we work with, and they're all experts within their department. The materials developer is working on the textiles, testing the membranes. We're working with pattern makers to make sure the fit and the articulation and the sleeves, elbows, gussets are optimized as good as we can. We make everything in-house, so we're constantly doing mock-ups ourselves or working with our sewers or our design developers who are taking those concepts and spinning them and trying to resolve them. We've got our color team. In the Ascent category at least, you know, the colors have to be really bright and high visibility, which is a part of the safety aspect of it. You don't want to get lost in the alpine, and if you need to be rescued, you want to be visible. Downstairs, we're lucky enough to have a tool shop. We can work with them if we have challenges in terms of how to actually manufacture something or how to produce something. Those guys are designers themselves and essentially come up with really clever, creative solutions of how to produce that product. And we work really closely with the after sales and warranty team. They're the guys that are seeing all the product that's coming back from the consumers. They can show us what's coming back, and then we can try to resolve that for the future iterations.
We talk to people every day that don't think they should be washing their Gore-Tex because it'll become less waterproof. Couldn't be further from the truth, and in fact, these days, it's even more imperative that you wash this stuff.
Yeah, and it's not hard. I mean, you wash your outdoor gear just the same as you wash any other gear. You do some different products in there, but the process is the same. You don't need any special equipment.
Your jacket will not last as long if you don't take care of it.
People are using these hard shells in harsh environments, and this is really your protection from those elements. Definitely work really closely with our athletes for field testing and just all around feedback, because they're really living in the product.
I've taken this jacket up things like Cerro Torre, new routes in remote areas of Patagonia like Turbio Valley, Norway, Baffin Island. I just came back from a 3-week trip alpine rock climbing in Greenland. We were putting up new routes. We climbed an unclimbed tower and put up a new 17 pitch rock climb on a big rock buttress. We were doing mostly alpine rock, but we did a little bit of snow and ice and mixed climbing as well, often on the approach. So something like the Alpha FL is the perfect piece for that.
You ever climbed an unclimbed mountain before?
No. That's pretty good. Good first one, hey? Not bad. Woo! Awesome.
Unnamed.
Unnamed.